We get asked the question all the time, how long is too long to powder after you print? And like most things in the DTF world, it really depends. So let's go deep and really understand what's happening when you powder your DTF prints. When I first started working with DTF, I noticed that prints that I ran through the automated dryer shaker tended to feel thinner than the ones that I hand powdered. I realized I was hand powdering as soon as the print came out of the printer, whereas the prints that were going through the dryer shaker weren't powdered for as much as 90 to 120 seconds. So we're gonna answer a few things today. What is the optimal window for powdering? And when is your unpowdered print a lost cause? We're going to test specific intervals, then curing them right after powdering. Then we'll press them all on a shirt and run them through a few washes and see how they hold up. We're printing these off. Basically, I'm starting the timer for when the print finishes. I've got the longest ones already printed out here, so they're gonna wait the longest. So I decided to print them first, but this is the first one that's like a 0 second. So this is the one that I need to powder immediately. There it goes. And we're gonna cut the film and go powder it right away. I was really hoping I could use the weight to compare like how much adhesive powder was sticking, but I probably need to do a bigger transfer if I wanna test that. Right now the metric's gonna be the look, the feel, and then when it presses, if it changes at all. Well, here we have it. From 0 seconds to 120 minutes, so 2 hours. I gotta be honest, the first, like basically up to about 2 minutes, I felt like there was a lot of adhesive powder going down it. But if I sit here and I feel the 0 seconds and the 120 minutes, this definitely feels thinner. The 0 seconds feels almost a little bit slippery. My guess is it's possible that there was so much adhesive powder that got on it that not all the glycerin kind of came out when it was curing. Really kind of what I found here was that up to about 2 minutes, maybe about 2 or 3 is where I really started to see a change. And then I honestly didn't see much of a change from 2 minutes till about almost 30 minutes. And then 30 minutes to 120, I started to see less and less powder going on it. So I'm gonna press all these on this shirt, and then I am gonna run it through the wash a handful of times. Honestly, don't think I'm gonna have any trouble, even with the one that waited 120 minutes to put powder on it. But we'll do that test, and then I'll come back and I'll give you my final thoughts on a recommended time window that you should be powdering your prints. All right, you just saw that the 0 seconds, 30 and 60 were not peeling quite right. And I'm not sure how much of that is the placement on the platen, like maybe it's not heating up as much up there, or maybe it's not as much pressure. So I gave another try and let's see if this works. Okay, that one worked better. That one's still snagging a little bit. Yeah, the 30 second is still wanting to snag. How about the minute? Nope. I said minute, I meant 0 seconds. Okay. So I am able to get it off, but it is not, you guys can see that on this back camera here. Okay, so there's some conclusive. Don't powder immediately after. Don't even powder 30 seconds after. Wait at least 90 seconds, bare minimum. All right, let's keep pressing the rest of these. Oh, FYI, this is why you don't wanna wait a long time to powder. Because sometimes you accidentally bump your print and now my fingerprint is permanently in this, but it's okay, it doesn't screw up our experiment. Yep, all those came off perfectly fine. Let's do the last ones. 25, 30, 60, 90, and 120 minutes. Now, if any of them are gonna not press properly, it's gonna be one of these guys. Perfect. All right, second press on these guys, and it's off to the washing machine. Here we go. And you can already see here where it's already kind of peeling up. I don't expect that to last too well. Yeah, I can tell a huge difference in the feel of the 120 minutes versus the 90 seconds. Even 3 minutes feels a little bit thicker, but it's not bad. All right, to the washing machine. All right, and I'm back, and this video feels like it's taking an eternity to make, but that's what happens when we try to do deep dives into technology and concepts within the DTF spaces. Sometimes it takes a while to test. So I took this home, I washed it. I think it was somewhere in the ballpark of 10 to 15 times, but I don't exactly recall. I kind of threw it into everybody's wash cycle. But I can definitely tell that the earlier time, so basically 0 seconds, all the way up to about 120, they're kind of deteriorating a little bit more, like even the 60 second here, and I'll get a tight shot on it. But even the 60 second here is kind of like breaking down a little bit when I stretch it. So not ideal. So you definitely want to wait at least 90 to 120 seconds before you powder. Going to the backside with 120 minute, this actually held up really quite well. It's still stretchy. I don't know that it's ideal. I would say the optimal time for powdering is between basically about 90 seconds and about 5 to 10 minutes. Like I think 90 seconds to 10 minutes, you're safe across the board. Even waiting 2 hours wasn't horrible. I don't suggest it, but if you've printed something and for some reason something got stalled up and you couldn't powder it for a long time, you could still powder that print up to an hour or even two after you printed it. So my official DTF Superstore stance on how long is too long to wait to powder, more than 2 hours is too long, but optimal is between 90 seconds and 10 minutes. Somewhere in that range is gonna be optimal for powdering. I hope this video helps give you guys a better understanding of what's happening in that powdering process. And if you guys have more questions or thoughts, definitely share them in the comments below. And if you want more DTF expert tips and tricks, make sure you subscribe to the channel so you don't miss out on any more of our deep dive videos. Thanks for watching. We'll see you next time.